Welcome to the ADCE Awards Gala.
Hello everyone and good evening. I would like to give you all the warmest welcome to the 31st ADCE Best of European Design and Advertising Awards. I'm delighted to be here today at the Design Museum in the beautiful city of Barcelona to help acknowledge the best that this industry has to offer. My name is Laura Suñol and I will be the host of tonight's gala. Thank you to all of you at home from all over Europe.
I'm really happy to find campaigns that really make me laugh.
There was one restaurant branding that went really innovative way in photography and design.
You can be creative in a completely new, unexpected and surprising way.
I am impressed that I see many more subjects regarding human rights and inclusion.
My attention was grabbed by pieces that are actually fun and impactful at the same time.
How creativity fights against the Russian invasion in Ukraine in a different way, in different work, it's kind of amazing.
The level of quality for this year is overall really good. Varies a little bit, but really impressive.
I'm very happy to see work from European countries that I don't usually get to see work from. So really happy to be judging this year.
The level of this year's works is 4 out of 5 for me, definitely.
And I'm really impressed by the variety of the subjects I see.
I believe that there are so many brilliant pieces from all over the Europe.
The level of this year's awarded work is kind of showing that creativity could fight against everything.
After watching the video, we can confirm that it was indeed a great experience for all those who took part in evaluating all the entries. And now, yes, we are going to talk to Alex, president of the ADCE, and find out how the experience has been in a particularly difficult year in Europe due to the knock-on effect of the war in Ukraine and the problems and tensions resulting from it. Alex, good evening and welcome.
Dear creators from all over Europe, well, even maybe some might watch from other countries around the world, welcome to the 31st Creative Festival of the Art Directors Club of Europe. I was thinking intensively about this little speech and after all about if it is right to organize a European Festival of Creativity this year at all, focusing on advertising and design, bringing people together from all over Europe, discussing ideas to sell or promote brands, products and services, well, consumption in general. While only a few kilometers away, people we know, friends, are trying to escape a terrible war and children are suffering hunger. We are all representatives of the European idea in times when there's a terrible and unbelievable war going on in the middle of our community. Nonetheless, I think it is more important than ever to use the power of creativity to make things visible, to then be able to change them. The most effective weapon to drive change is creativity. And creativity used as the one and only peaceful weapon in the world is unbeatable. Well, so we decided to go on with the festival and celebrate the power of creativity coming from countries all across Europe. To finally prove that the impact of understanding what drives people, the impact of making things visible, is the weapon that we, the European creative community, hold in our hands. We also at the same time took the decision to suspend the Russian club, which means we did not accept any entries from Russia this year. Whereas generally the ADCE of Europe wants to stay neutral within a political conflict, especially if we have friends and dedicated members on both sides of the conflict. Nonetheless, in this case, it was for us, it was not possible to not take a stand. As a community that celebrates communication, we cannot accept any form of physical violence. This was not a decision against the Russian creative community and all the friends that we have in Russia. Not at all, but against the Russian government. We want to help to isolate the country that took the decision to actively attack another country. On the other hand, we accepted all entries coming from Ukraine for free, as a sign to our strong belief that any conflict can be solved by communication. The ADCE of Europe in general passionately believes that only if we are a diverse, connected and collaborative European creative community, we can solve complex problems. The ADCE of Europe is a platform where the creative community unites to interact and foster, explore and promote creativity as a multi-solution approach. And the ADCE of Europe educates, inspires and exchanges knowledge and experiences by leveraging the diversity of European creativity. And especially diversity is what we believe in and what makes us special. Let's celebrate our differences instead of trying to convince others from our own beliefs. Wouldn't it be the most boring world of all worlds in this galaxy if we would all be the same? Well, go to understand different cultures, mindsets, and beliefs, and let's celebrate every new experience that we can make. This is the basis of the European idea, which should be, by the way, today more than ever, a role model to this truly crazy world. The ADCE of Europe also wants to celebrate and foster young talents by inventing educational programs, which give the possibility to our members to work in different countries, to listen and learn for a few weeks, or participate on challenging workshops with creative peers from all across Europe. By the way, well, we should maybe listen to the young ones even more often. I think this is never wrong. As for today's digital festival, besides sharing the results of the jury's work and therefore sharing some truly amazing creative ideas and executions, we have put together seven what we call creative pills. So we ask seven different European creatives from seven different European countries to answer the following question. So for now, enjoy the first two pills coming from Monika Bielskita, futures researcher from Lithuania, and Vladimir Strejcek, director of Draw, etc. from Czech Republic. And personally, I would ask you to never forget two things. The first thing is that it is our differences that makes us special. It's the differences that makes us humans. And second, it is the unbelievable power of creativity, which is a very, very strong weapon that we hold in our hands to drive change. So thank you for listening and enjoy the show.
European insights. How would you define European creativity?
Well, I think European creativity is going through really significant change, and that is because of the integration of Eastern European creatives into that sort of much more homogenous Western European sort of aesthetic and cultural landscape. But besides that, and I would think even more importantly, that finally European creativity is opening up to diasporic global South communities that are really, really enriching the creative expression of what Europe is. And so that's really what I'm excited about to see even more of in the future.
I think that the people who are creative are like small children. I think that we are full of the playful, that we are playing with our work. And I think that a lot of people in creative industry are not working, if you understand me. I think that it's not about European creativity, but it's about creative people, and doesn't matter from where they are. And I'm a lucky guy because I'm working with really creative people from all around the world. And it's about the creativity on the beginning of the work. And then there is the sweet finish when everybody are satisfied and so on. So creativity for me is part of the work.
Now let's see which projects have been awarded to whom this year. But first, let me tell you how these awards work. There are 53 leading creatives from 20 European countries. They met online first and after in person here in Barcelona and voted for the best of the best from this year. We had 874 entries from 24 different countries across Europe. So how does it work? There are two categories of student, young creative, six professional categories and five special awards. We will announce all the gold winners throughout the gala, and from all the gold winners from each category, we will be announcing one nominee for the Grand Prix and the four others ADCE Special Awards. And now, let's get to the moment you've all been waiting for, this year's winners. Let's start with the category of promising young talent, students and young creatives. This is for students and young professionals under the age of 28, who were the winners of their respective national competitions. Let's see what they can surprise us with.
Student of the Year. Gold in Graphic Design, Product Design goes to Molda by Marvin Stegman, Maximilian Wolf for DHBW Ravensburg, Germany.
Mold is disgusting and is generally received as repulsive and negative. But can mold also be beautiful? Can mold become an aesthetic design tool by eliminating disgust? In the work Molder, sofas are presented, which are provided with mold optics. With the help of a configurator, the viewer can create a unique piece that questions the perception of the mold aesthetic. From the original disgust, a luxury product is created to feel good. The product is composed of two components: the furniture itself and the mold cover. The sofa is made of a fungal material. This is a substrate of agricultural waste, which is grown through by a fungus. It can be filled into any shape, and after the growth process, it is a stable unit. The mold cover itself is made of a fabric fur, as it has a visually similar structure to that of the mold, due to its many hairs. This imitation decays the disgust factor and contributes to the well-being through its haptics. In the process, an exchange of materials occurs. The sofa is ultimately made of fungus, and the mold is made of fabric. This gives the impression that the sofa is moldy, but without any health concerns or other negative consequences. The mold is substituted by a fur, which creates confidence and coziness. The sofa is made of a new, still unfamiliar material. Thus, it is achieved that the viewer feels with regard to the materials, rather to the mold. A strong break is created. The more mold covers the sofa, the cozier it becomes and the more comfortable you will feel on it. With the help of a configurator, mold is playfully used as a design tool. The wealth of variants is presented and the growth of mold is thematized. The basic shape, size, color, and type of mold can be determined. The configuration process ends with the determination of how heavily the sofa should be covered. The sofas are shown exemplary in luxurious apartments to make it easier for the viewer to imagine them in a real application. The Molder project manages to deal intensively with mold and its visuality. A linkage of two topics takes place, which would exclude each other in the first moment. Thus, new possibilities of design are opened. Mold becomes comfortable and beautiful.
Gold in Communication Ideas goes to Born Guilty by Filmakademie Baden-Württemberg for Innocence Project, Germany.
I was never the athletic type of guy. I was just a normal kid from the Bronx. But when your life turns into a marathon, you better start running.
It's a story making national headlines.
His name is Hugh Burton.
Accused of killing his own mother.
Mother was stabbed and killed.
Murdered by her own son. He was 16 years old.
The victim was cracked, okay?
Although everything points to a sexual event.
The day I lost my mother, I lost everything. I never thought there would be more to lose. When they blame you as guilty, there's this tiny thought that gradually becomes reality. And at some point, you start to believe it.
I did it.
Say, what did you do?
All of you. I did it. I did it.
One decision that changes your life forever. My mother always told me, tell the truth, no matter what. I should have listened to her. I firmly believed that someone would come and get me out of here. I'm not supposed to be here.
Please, Father, help me.
At a certain point, you realize that your situation is hopeless. I faced an enemy who was superior. And you were the one who allowed them to do this to me.
I did it.
Mistake was being a child.
Best Young Creative. Gold in Graphic Design, Product Design goes to Emory, Emotion Regulation Application by Darta Galina, Sandra Sugaku, Ricard Zunin Zutans for Art Academy of Latvia, Rigas Stradins University, Ventspils University, Latvia. Gold in Communication Ideas goes to The Equal Kit by Tuomas Kahvonen, TVWH Helsinki, Finland, for Football Association of Finland, Finland.
Je vous demande de bien vouloir demander à cette personne de retirer son voile.
Suomessa meidän on ollut haastavampi saada maahanmuuttajataustaisia tyttöjä mukaan harrastuksen ja seuratoiminnan pariin. Ja sitä kautta haluttiin tehdä tämä aloite siinä, että toivotetaan kaikki aidosti tervetulleeksi.
They give me Nike hijab.
Congratulations to the Football Association of Finland for winning the awards in the brand development category.
Wow, these youngsters have very bright futures. Congratulations, guys.
European insights. How would you define European creativity?
My definition of European creativity is that it has a very special place, especially in art and in music. Here we employ artificial intelligence. We just did this Beethoven project where artificial intelligence helped us to be more creative.
For me, creativity in Europe is strongly rooted in European multilingual and multinational situation. Historical tradition to translate, to trade knowledge has made Europe an excellent environment for creativity.
I would define European creativity as not very different from the rest of the world. I think now is quite similar to other places in the world. So I don't like to define like this is different from other places. I would say that it's a creativity full of energy, vibrant, a lot of people with a lot of talent, but I don't think it's just for Europe, it's worldwide.
Is there anything that makes us different from the rest of the world?
It's not just only the language, it's our thinking and it's our attitude to be creative. We have a long-standing tradition and it shows in the artworks we do, and now with the help of artificial intelligence, it is really unique.
So I think it's multicultural and it's a worldwide creativity. I don't like to define like it's different from the rest of the world. We have like different things apart.
Well, having now recognized the talents of the new generations of creatives, it's time for the professional categories. We will announce all book winners from each category, and at the end of each, we will see the work that has been nominated for the Grand Prix final. Then we will speak to a juror or president from the category to comment on why they nominated it for the Grand Prix. Don't forget to check out the ADCE website at the end of the gala, where you can find all the gold winners' works, and it's seriously worth it. And now, for film and audio, it was a very close call, as there are some great projects, and let's find out who the winners are.
Film and audio. Two gold in TV cinema commercials and craft direction cinematography and editing goes to The Wish by Service Plan Germany for Penny Germany. Gold in online videos goes to No Drama by Wirtsgrupp AG for Switzerland Tourism, Switzerland. Two gold in online videos and craft music and sound goes to Zalando Pre-Owned, Drama Free by Accenture Song Germany for Zalando Germany. Gold in film and audio for non-profit, public service, NGO goes to Kino Dopomoha, Series of Dark Stories by Kino Dopomoha for Kino Dopomoha, Ukraine. Gold in Craft, Direction, Cinematography and Editing goes to 1 by BBDO for WhatsApp, Germany. Gold in Craft, Animation, VFX, CGI and 3D goes to The Spider and the Window by Leo Burnett for Samsung Electronics, Germany. Gold in Craft, Animation, VFX, CGI and 3D goes to An Unlikely Friendship by CYW for Prime Video, Spain.
Fantastic work, guys. It's a pleasure to see these award-winning pieces that really could be considered true works of art. Do you know which of these award winners has been nominated to become a Grand Prix finalist? We asked Richard Brim, president of the Film and Audio Jury, and this is what he told us. Richard, please.
Hi, my name's Richard Brim, and I'm president of the Film and Audio Jury. And the piece we've chosen for Grand Prix is The Wish for Penny. Words like perfect and completely, the complete package, and descriptions like that were used when talking about this one piece of work. It felt really timely. It felt beautifully acted. It felt beautifully directed. The idea was compelling, and people didn't see coming. The performance, everything about it was described by my jury as being sort of perfect and a complete package. And that's why we chose The Wish by Penny.
The Grand Prix nominee in film and audio is The Wish by Service Plan Germany for Penny, Germany.
Kannst du auch nicht schlafen?
Nee.
Was wünschst du dir eigentlich zu Weihnachten?
Ich wünsche mir, dass du nicht immer zu Hause rumhängst. Dass du dich einfach rausschleißt.
Ja, ich bin gleich da.
Wir nicht wissen, wo du bist. Ich wünsche mir, dass Papa dich abholen muss, weil du viel zu viel getrunken hast. Ich wünsche mir, dass du die Schule schleifen lässt. Weil dir alles andere wichtiger ist. Weil es dir scheißegal ist, was ich davon halte. Ich wünsche mir, dass du hier heimlich eine Party feierst. Und dass du diesem Mädchen endlich sagst, dass du sie liebst. Losziehst. Ich mag dich. zurückbekommst.
And it's now or never. I'm gonna live forever. I just wanna live while I'm alive. My heart is like an open highway. Like Frankie said, I did it my way. I just wanna live while I'm alive.
We now know the first candidate for the Grand Prix this year, and the second one will be one of the winners of the next category, print and outdoor. Let's see which projects have impressed our jury and are worthy of a gold. Roll the video.
Print and outdoor. Three gold in outdoor, special outdoor, and print and outdoor for nonprofit public service NGO goes to Motherland Pride by Sachi and Sachi, Ukraine, for Kyiv Pride, Ukraine. Two gold in digital screens and print and outdoor for nonprofit public service and NGO goes to Fight Sexism with Sexism by Think AG, Think Munich, for Ursula Karven, Frauen 100, Helen Kaher Communications, Germany. Gold in direct marketing goes to Very Important Stamps by Accenture Song Germany, for International Society for Human Rights, German section, Germany. Gold in direct marketing goes to Show Us Equal by Accenture Song Germany, for German Olympic Sports Confederation, Germany.
Given the standard of the award winners, it would be very difficult for me to choose a Grand Prix candidate. Let's see what this category jury thinks. This is the one they have recommended for this year's top award. Slava Denis, president of Print and Outdoor, tell us why they have nominated it, and let's take a look.
I'm Slava Denis. I'm a president of the category Printed Outdoor. We are submitting the work Motherland for the Grand Prix. We like this work very much because it's provocative, innovative, and very surprising. The problem of LGBT issue is very unnoticeable in Ukraine, and we like this work because it brings this topic on the very big scale, because this monument of Motherland is the biggest in Ukraine and even in Europe. And it always had an image of very strong lady, iron lady, which really doesn't pay attention to such not important things. So it's like the very interesting approach to make an ambient advertising in outdoor when the drones take the big flag for a couple of minutes and only some people can take pictures and journalists can just grasp the image. And that's almost like, you know, like the work you cannot really touch because it's kind of disappearing. And that's why it's so surprising and it's touching you so much. And it's innovative and it's very well crafted. And I think it's really a big idea. And they say that even your mother should pay attention to such things. So I like this connection between the issue of LGBT and mother and the motherland, the lady who really did not pay attention to such things. And now every mother in Ukraine can really pay attention to this problem. So congratulations to people who made it. And I very hope that we will have much more ideas like this.
The Grand Prix nominee in Print and Outdoor is Motherland Pride by Sachi and Sachi Ukraine for Kyiv Pride, Ukraine.
Pride is important for the entire LGBT community because it's a moment of visibility.
If you cannot be seen, you cannot be heard. The Motherland Monument was built in 1981 and became the tallest European statue. It is supposed to be a symbol of victory and protection, but even now in modern Ukraine, human rights are not protected. We had to do something to wake up the society. With the help of drones, we hacked the monument by attaching the huge rainbow flag to its sword in real time. The statue symbolism was suddenly transformed from the protection of Soviet values to human rights protection. What looked like a simple stunt needed careful preparation. We only had one chance to make this happen. The public reaction was huge. Everybody from members of parliament to stand-up comedians started to talk about it. This image became iconic. Year after, this visual became a main symbol of series of city events. The stunt ended fast, but its power will last in time. The Kyiv Pride event became visible all across the world. A simple, bold idea proving that Ukraine is ready for change.
And what do you think? Do you agree with the jury? Make your predictions and be part of the popular jury. Follow ADCE's Instagram stories and vote for your favorite work for the Grand Prix and see if you agree with the final result. The quiz will be open after the Integrated and Innovation nominee has been unveiled. Now, let's get to know a category that is becoming more and more important in an increasingly digitalized society. Let's see which projects are going to set the trend in interactive and mobile in this edition of the ADCE.
Interactive and mobile. Gold in Interactive Design goes to Fuck You. An Educational Revolution by Loved and Think for O Foundation, Germany. Gold in Place-Specific Experiences goes to The Oldest Model in the World by Demner, Merlisak and Bergman for Zalando, Austria. Gold in Interactive and Mobile for Nonprofit Public Service NGO goes to Hit Jäger, Anti-Fascist Algorithms by Philipp und Kuncha for Laut gegen Nazis, Germany. Gold in Digital Service Experience goes to Lasker Upcycle Merch by Bickerstaff 734 for Lasker Charity Store, Ukraine.
Well done, guys. You should be very proud of yourself. Let's find out which of these projects, according to the Interactive and Mobile Jury, has a top chance of winning the Grand Prix. Belén Coca, president of this category, tell us about it.
We've chosen this piece for the Grand Prix because it shows a great way to use technology to tackle a social issue, as is the creation of Nazi content in platforms. What they did was to create a fake band, a fake Nazi band, and use it as a Trojan horse to get introduced by playing with the algorithm in Nazi followers. And there are like three interesting points in the campaign. One is the topic, which is socially relevant. Then the use of technology, because it's a technology algorithm technology used in a very unexpected way. And the third one is the results, because they not only fooled the Nazi followers, but they got the platforms to take out the Nazi content of the music platform.
The Grand Prix nominee in Interactive and Mobile is Hit Jaeger, Anti-Fascist Algorithms by Philipp und Kuncha for Laut gegen Nazis, German.
Neo-Nazis in Germany. Their presence grows every day. The gateway into the scene. Music. Once in secret, but today, here. Super easy to find. And what's even worse, once you listen to fascist music, the streaming algorithms will suggest more and more. We wanted the platforms to think of their duty of care. So instead of pushing more extremist bands, we forced their algorithms to recommend us. Hetz Jaeger, a Trojan Nazi band. These algorithms recommend bands to users based on four parameters. Hetz Jaeger was optimized to cater to all of them. After analyzing countless extreme right-wing rock tracks, we composed a teaser tailored to the audio characteristics of this genre. Far-right buzzwords and syntax formed the basis for our lyrics, and visually, we also followed the codes of the scene. With the help of artist affinity targeting, we sneaked the teaser directly into the streams and playlists of neo-Nazi music fans. We infiltrated Telegram groups and ensured these fans made a big fuss over Hetz Jaeger on social media. They spread the word themselves. So the algorithms finally got the message. Hetz Jaeger is the new neo-Nazi rock band. Our teaser was recommended to far-right music listeners over 120,000 times in just 1 month. We finally released the full song on the anniversary of Hitler's seizure of power. But the second part of the track reveals it all. It's a statement against fascism and the platforms that offer such bands a stage. An outcry from the far right, applause from the left. Over 200,000 supporters shared, liked, and commented on the initiative.
Well, I hope you are enjoying these beautiful projects we are seeing here today as much as I am. And it's now time for a very distinctive category at the ADCEs, the design. Do you want to know which projects blew the jury away this year? Me too, so let's take a look.
Design. Gold in editorial design goes to Seabound, a logbook. By Dog Design for Elina Brotherus, Finland. Two gold, corporate brand identity and photography goes to Sitco Pizza by Verklig for Sitco Pizza, Finland. Gold in corporate brand identity goes to Klaipeda City Visual Identity by Critical Plus XY Agency for Klaipeda City, Lithuania. Gold in logotype goes to Corteza, the Island of a Mystery, by Pickerstaff 734 for Corteza National Reserve, Ukraine. Gold in illustration goes to Greek Spirits by Superman, by Odd Bleat for Superman, Greece. Gold in illustration goes to El Gallipote by Not Perfect Vilnius for UAB Vilnius Degtine, Lithuania. Gold in packaging goes to Balsen Global Relaunch by Argo Design for Balsen, Italy. Gold in spatial design goes to Normal Restaurant Signage by Run Design for Restaurant Normal, Alcalle de Can Roca, Spain. Gold in spatial design goes to Da Spazio Dimenticato a Spazio della Memoria by Simone Brillarelli for Mercato Centrale Milano, Italy. Gold in design, any other, goes to Flutwein, Our Worst Vintage, by 7.1 Ad Factory Creative House plus White Rabbit Budapest, for AHR, A Wine Region Needs Help for Rebuilding, Germany.
Pedro Mesquita, president of the design jury, please come with us and share Why have you chosen this piece?
We believe that good design is good business, and we discuss the risks for the clients when they invest a lot of money in changing. Boston is an amazing project because their rebranding and the new packaging have a new vision for the brand. Congratulations to Boston. They are the best of show in design.
The Grand Prix nominee in design is Boston Global Relaunch by Odge Design for Boston, Italy.
The category shows us how far advertising and communication have evolved in general. Let's take a look at the gold-winning projects in the brand experience category.
Brand experience. Gold in promotions goes to Flutwein, Our Worst Vintage by 7.1 Ad Factory Creative House plus White Rabbit Budapest. For AHR, a wine region needs help for rebuilding. Germany. Two gold in live stunts, brand activation, and PR events goes to Motherland Pride by Saatchi & Saatchi Ukraine. For Kyiv Pride, Ukraine. Gold in new use of media goes to City Life Billboard by Philipp und Kuncha for Pins and Kunst, Germany. Gold in PR events goes to Water of Africa by Collettivo Creativo for Action Against Hunger, Italy.
Congratulations on this well-deserved recognition, guys. Good job. Which of the winning projects in the brand experience category has what it takes to become the next ADCE Grand Prix champion? Allow Stefania Siani, chairman of the jury in this category, to tell us.
I'm Stefania Siani, I'm the president of the brand experience jury, and we believe that in time of activism, it's important to stay relevant and create projects that start conversation. That's why we nominate for the ADCE Grand Prix the Motherland Pride, a project that touched the main topics of our times, the human rights of LGBT community, and of course, last but not least, the capability to create an instant classic. In Ukraine, Pride event was cancelled, they used drones to hack the tallest statue in Europe and to transform it, to evolve it from protection of Soviet values into a symbol of human rights, and that's great.
The Grand Prix nominee in brand experience is Motherland Pride by Saatchi & Saatchi Ukraine for Kyiv Pride, Ukraine.
We imagine that you are all curious to know which project will be considered as number one. There's not much time left to find out. And remember, popular voting will be open after this category's Grand Prix nominee announcement. Go to the ADCE Instagram and have your say. Let's move on to the last category before we get to the special awards. This is known as Integrated and Innovation, where professionals unleash their creativity to find even more surprising ways to make an impact on the audience. Speaking of making an impact, let's see which projects have done so on the jury this time.
Integrated and innovation. Gold in integrated campaigns for commercial brands goes to Colors of the Slopes by Swisscom and AndyLusty.com for Swisscom, Switzerland. Gold in integrated and innovation for non-profit public service NGO goes to Act Against Algorithm by Jung von Matt Donau for Vienna Tourist Board, Austria. Gold in branded content goes to Carbonara by Alchemy for Barilla, Italy. Gold in best use of technology goes to The Most Important Call by Not Perfect Vilnius for Strong Together, Lithuania. Gold in best use of data goes to The Uncertain Four Seasons by Jung von Matt for United Nations, Germany. Product service innovation goes to Flutwein, Our Worst Vintage by 7.1 Ad Factory Creative House plus White Rabbit Budapest for AHR, A Wine Region Needs Help for Rebuilding, Germany.
Congratulations to all of the teams involved. One of these projects has been chosen by the jury to qualify for the Grand Prix. Alexander Jaggi, chairman of this category, tell us why.
This year we had a great jury group, integrated in innovation, really important group, a really important area to judge things. And we had a great discussion, and in the end we had a broad sense also of our favorites that we picked for the Grand Prix nominee. It's called Act Against Algorithm for the Vienna Tourism Board. We like this campaign because it puts something in the center which is really important in these days, the censorship and also the self-censorship of the social media. We thought it was a clever case in the first sense put on for a narrow target group. But after that, with the PR campaign, it made it really broad and bigger. So this was really a top work we really liked and discussed a lot about it. And it has also some cheekiness to it, which we also liked. It's not only compassionate, it's also a cheekiness combined with art. So we really like that. This is our Grand Prix nominee.
The Grand Prix nominee in Integrated and Innovation is Act Against Algorithm by Jung von Matt Donau for Vienna Tourist Board, Austria.
Vienna is home to some of the world's most iconic artworks. 100 years ago, these artists fought for the free expression of their art. 100 years later, Facebook and Instagram's algorithms make their fight obsolete and label Viennese art pornographic, leading to blocked accounts and deleted posts. We wanted to bring the discussion about nude art back to where it belongs, in the hands of people, not algorithms.
Vienna's tourism board is trying a different approach, showcasing the museum's art on OnlyFans. Great!
Vienna strips on OnlyFans, a protest movement for artistic freedom on social media. We took every piece of censored art and published them on OnlyFans, which allows 18+ content for subscribers, protesting the censorship of art, promoting Vienna's historic sexual liberty, and Vienna's most famous museums, all while hijacking the platform. Every subscription on OnlyFans granted free entry to Vienna's museums. A simple move that started a global discussion. 2.5 billion impressions, 150 million engagements.
Für internationales Aufsehen sorgt gerade eine PR-Aktion von Wien Tourismus, weil bestimmte Kunstwerke.
More than 2,500 articles worldwide, media coverage reaching over 730 million people. While spending zero on media. Advertising Vienna as an open destination in the midst of a global tourism crisis. Vienna strips on OnlyFans, a protest movement for artistic freedom on social media.
Special Awards.
So far, we've met the winners in the usual categories of the festival, but there are still some very special prizes to be awarded. ADCE stands for the value of Europeans' cultural diversity and believes of passionately in the power of creativity to help solve complex issues related to this. This is why the ADCE Awards has created four special prizes to recognize and put the spotlight on works that use creativity as a powerful tool to promote specific values. These awards are given to campaigns that stand out across all categories, whether commercially driven or done to help the community. Let's see which projects are worthy of winning this year's ADCE Special Awards.
European star, Johannes Nefkla.
The first is the European star, Johannes Nefkla Award. It pays tribute to one of the founders of the ADCE, Johannes Nefkla, who was a believer in the European community and dedicated all his life to supporting and promoting excellence in European creativity. The European Star Johannes Nefkla Award rewards works that reflect European values such as freedom, justice, and the promotion of peace. It's truly an honor to present the project that deserves this award. Let's check it out.
The European Star Johannes Nefkla winner is Motherland Pride by Sachi and Sachi Ukraine for Kyiv Pride Ukraine.
Pride is important for the entire LGBT community because it's a moment of visibility.
If you cannot be seen, you cannot be heard. The Motherland Monument was built in 1981 and became the tallest European statue. It is supposed to be a symbol of victory and protection, but even now in modern Ukraine, human rights are not protected. We had to do something to wake up the society. With the help of drones, we hacked the monument by attaching the huge rainbow flag to its sword in real time. The statue symbolism was suddenly transformed from the protection of Soviet values to human rights protection. What looked like a simple stunt needed careful preparation. We only had one chance to make this happen. The public reaction was huge. Everybody from members of parliament to stand-up comedians started to talk about it. This image became iconic. Year after, this visual became a main symbol of series of city events. The stunt ended fast, but its power will last in time. The Kyiv Pride event became visible all across the world. A simple, bold idea, proving that Ukraine is ready for change.
We have the winners here to congratulate them in person and to know the details of their beautiful project. Welcome, Sachi and Sachi Ukraine.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, ADCE Europe. It's a great honor for our project to won that prize. I know that in previous years the European Star became such amazing projects like Lifeboat, like Uncensored Library, and now we saw. I'm happy. I'm very happy for our agency, for our team. Of course, for our country in that hard times. As I said, it's a great result, it's a great teamwork, and I want to praise all of the team. My friend and co-creator Kostya Schneider, who is absent on this cold due to electricity problem. Also want to say thank you to Jörg Rommi. He pushes us over our limits, and also want to say thank you to Armed Forces of Ukraine, because with their help we could work now, we could do our best in advertising, to compete, to win. That's it. It's thank you for ADC Europe, for I know how your organization support Ukraine and our creators, and I also want to I highly appreciate this, and I want to say thank you guys. You do an amazing job now for us.
Many thanks and congratulations to the whole team. Let's move on to the next award.
Genius Loki.
In Europe, we are lucky to have a wealth of cultural heritage. And this is precisely what this award is all about. It's the ADCE Genius Loki, an award that rewards a work which demonstrates the spirit of a particular place within the exceptionality, rich European cultural heritage. The deserved winner of this Genius Loki Award is...
The Genius Loki winner is Corteza, the Island of a Mystery, by Bickerstaff 734 for Corteza National Reserve, Ukraine.
Let's find out what it feels like to win a prize as special as this one. Bickerstaff 734, are you there? Congratulations.
First of all, thank you very much for your attention to our project and for this award. It's a big honor for us. The Hortice project is more important to us than ever before, because every Ukrainian knows that it's not an ordinary island somewhere in Ukraine. It's a really special place for us, for Ukrainians. Actually, when we were working on this project, we have a trip to Zaporizhia and we visited this island. And you know, there are a lot of different, I don't know, like school books, a lot of articles on Wikipedia, but actually they can't explain you what actually this place is. You can understand it only when you are there. And you can feel this power and energy of this place. So Hortice is a source of Ukrainian ancient power and mystery. And we decided to leave this mystery to the island. Quite literally, we asked people to uncover their own stories about this place. For example, me and Ilya, we have our own stories too. But the main and the most important thing for us during this project is that Hortice is the symbol of Ukrainian independence, democracy and freedom. Now you can realize how it was to work on such projects It was a huge responsibility and a big honor for us. So thank you very much for your attention to our project. Thank you very much that now our work has a worldwide response. And we hope that really, really soon you can, all of you can visit our country and see this beautiful place, Horta. Thank you very much.
We are very hope that soon Ukraine will be win in this war and everyone will be able to see the brand in life in the Horta, Iceland. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So much.
Thank you for sharing your feelings with us, Speaker Staff 734.
Green Star.
Now it's time for an award that is totally planet friendly, the ADCE Green Star. This award aims to reward a work that promotes a circular economy, sustainability, or the protection of the environment. Fortunately, every year we have more and more projects with this admirable objective. And the contentious winner of this award is.
The Green Star winner is Bihar, Choosing Tomorrow by Llorente Cuenca for BBK Foundation, Spain.
Es la imagen que nos ha impactado a muchos ver.
La aparición de la cabeza gigante de una niña ahogándose en aguas de la ría.
Se da la impresión de que se está ahogando.
Una alegoría, una metáfora sobre cómo la sociedad puede hundir a nuestra juventud o también sacarla a flote.
How their actions can sink us or keep us afloat.
Nuestras acciones pueden hacer a gente o se afogar o flutuar.
Expectación para ver de cerca la cabeza en la ría.
Con centenares de curiosos agolpados en las barandillas de la ría.
Es tecnología, es una obra de ingeniería, pero al mismo tiempo es obra de arte.
We created a living, hyper-realistic sculpture. The first work created to sink or come afloat with every rising tide. A sculpture of beer, tomorrow in Basque, that served to grab people's attention and tell its own tale. A short film designed along with futurists and researchers that show the plausible consequences of our actions.
Un impacto al sentimiento del ser humano.
Sí, definitivamente es que cumplió su objetivo, llamar la atención.
Wow, появление инсталляции вызвало смешин.
Bihar ka arth aane wala kal hota hai.
Todo forma parte de una campaña de la BBK.
Thanks to its reach, Abbas chose beer to represent climate anxiety at the COP. When everything was ready, nature reminded us why we were doing this.
Congratulations, Llorente and Cuenca! Are you there? We would love to know how you're feeling right now.
Hello, hi everyone. Thank you very much for this award. And thank you to the jury for choosing us. For us, it's a huge success that we can connect with BR with so many people in so many different countries. So thank you. We are extremely happy. And I would like to say also thank you to our client, to BBK, for his bravery, and to our team for making it look easier. Thank you, everyone. Bye.
New Equal Star.
Now for the last of these special awards, the new ADCE Equal Star. This is a new award created this year. It was inspired by the same award created by the Italian club, and it looks to reward works that promote inclusion, gender equality, and resistance against all forms of discrimination, as well as celebrating the creativity that helps to overcome stereotypes.
The Equal Star winner is The Discovery Billboards by Acne, a Deloitte business, for Terre des Hommes, Italy.
Italy has the lowest score in the EU Gender Equality Index in the domain of work.
By age 12, 50% of girls' career aspirations are influenced by stereotypes rooted in a tradition that marginalized women for centuries. In Milan, the number of statues celebrating great women is zero. That's why Terre des Hommes, one of the most active NGOs promoting gender equality, offered to the city's children a new perspective on the past to make them imagine a different future. Introducing the Discovery Billboards, the first child-hype billboard campaign inspiring a change in perspective and inviting children to discover female role models to look up to, like Rita Levi-Montalcini, an Italian Nobel laureate who inspired a whole generation, Malala, who encouraged millions of women to fight for their emancipation, and many more. A campaign aimed not only at children, but at any adult who cares about their point of view. And in just a few hours, the debate reached every channel.
Questo cambio di prospettiva è quello che serve in questo 8 marzo.
Terre des Hommes Italia ha lanciato una petizione che ho firmato, che si chiama Una statua per le bambine. Anche le donne.
Io sono entusiasta che ci sia questa iniziativa. Faremo in modo che le statue diventino statue vere di donne in tutta la città.
A Milano su 121 statue non ce n'era una che raffigurasse una donna. Da poco c'è la prima.
Ecco la prima statua dedicata ad una donna. Lo slamento poco fa da parte del sindaco Sala.
Let's find out a bit more about this interesting project from its creator. Congratulations, Agne! What can you tell us about it?
First of all, thank you very much. We are all honored and happy for this important recognition, especially because it is connected with the values that inspired us in Acne. When we launched Acne in Italy back in September 2020, was in the middle of the COVID year, the COVID crisis. And we decided to focus, of course, on winning clients and projects, but also on giving back. Giving back something to our city that was suffering a lot at that time, and our society. And that is how we started working with Terre des Hommes, which is an NGO still with low awareness globally, but very active in the defense of children's rights. And one important right is the one to have dreams and aspiration. So speaking with them, we understood that we could help by putting our talent at work on this topic in our country, a country with the lowest score in the European Gender Equality Index, where the 50% of girls' career aspirations are still influenced by stereotypes, and especially in a city where we had 120 statues dedicated to men, and zero dedicated to women. Now, the best result is that also thanks to this work, the situation changed. Now we have two statues dedicated to very inspiring women, and a big applause should go to the to our mayor in Milan. I just want lastly to thank you because this is an award that will surely encourage us, but hopefully will encourage all the agencies who are working creatively about this topic in Italy, to keep working to make a change, as there is still a lot of work to be done, especially in Italy. Thank you very much again.
European insights. How would you define European creativity?
Well, I think it's hard to define European creativity. Actually, to define is to limit. We cannot put France and Germany in the same basket or Switzerland and Italy. I mean, we have so many differences. But I think on one thing we can all agree, that Europe was created by history. And I believe that the emotional inheritance of European history lives also across our creative ideas.
European creativity for me is unique by its diversity of ideas, insights, and executions, because on such a small piece of land such as Europe, we have so many different cultures and countries living next to each other. So you have like different markets. So for example,
You have big players like Germany, France, or Italy, but you also have small players like Slovakia, where the budgets are much smaller. So in order to make a big creative impact, you have to hack the system and think outside the box, because you don't have money for execution, so the idea is the holy grail.
Is there anything that makes us different from the rest of the world?
I think that what makes us different from the end of the world is that we have an enormous legacy of stories to draw from, that we can interpret and reinterpret endlessly. Some people might think that it could be our limit, but personally, I do think that this is our treasure.
I think what makes us different from the rest of the world, I think each country or each person is unique to himself. So of course there is everything that makes us different from the rest of the world. But like I said, in Europe, what's very specific is that we have so many cultures living next to each other for so many years. So there's like thousands of years of culture deeply rooted in our living.
Well, I don't know about you, but I've already got goosebumps. We are about to experience perhaps the most exciting moment of the night. The moment when we reveal which project wins the biggest prize in this competition. In just a moment, we will know how the professional jury voted. But if you want to know what the popular jury voted for in the Instagram quiz, you will find out the results in the chat. Stick around.
Grand Prix.
The final Grand Prix goes to the best word selected by the whole jury among all gold winners from its category. The Grand Prix is the work that stands out due to its creative concept and its perfect execution while setting the bar for excellence in creativity throughout the year. And the long-awaited winner of this award is...
The Grand Prix winner for 2022 goes to The Wish by Service Plan Germany for Penny, Germany.
Kannst du auch nicht schlafen?
Nee.
Was wünschst du dir eigentlich zu Weihnachten?
Ich wünsch mir, dass du nicht immer zu Hause rumhängst. Dass du dich einfach rausschleichst.
Ja, ich bin gleich da.
Wir nicht wissen, wo du bist. Ich wünsche mir, dass Papa dich abholen muss, weil du viel zu viel getrunken hast. Ich wünsche mir, dass du die Schule schleifen lässt. Weil dir alles andere wichtiger ist. Weil es dir scheißegal ist, was ich davon halte. Ich wünsche mir, dass du hier heimlich eine Party feierst. Und dass du diesem Mädchen endlich sagst, dass du sie liebst. Losziehst. Ich mag dich. Ich wünsche mir einfach, dass du deine Jugend zurückbekommst.
And it's now or never. I'm gonna live forever. I just wanna live while I'm alive. My heart is like an open highway. Like Frankie said, I did it my way. I just wanna live while I'm alive.
Wow, what a wonderful work. They deserve it a lot. Congratulations to the team involved, who, by the way, are here with us to tell us their reactions upon hearing the news. It's possible to explain in words what you're feeling right now, service plan?
We're so happy to hear the news because this is a very special project to us. It was a real hard project and every one of us was involved by our whole corazon. So that's why we're really, really happy. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I can say something. So we still are overwhelmed by the success of this project and so thankful to the whole team, to the production company, to the great director, lighting department, camera, music, all the departments, very, very talented guys. And it was a great, great pleasure and a great experience for us to do this job, to make this happen.
And that's all for the 31st edition of the ADCE Awards Best of European Design and Advertising 2022. As of this moment, all winners will be unveiled on the website, meaning gold, silver, and bronze winner from 24 countries. Congratulations to all of the winners. Thanks to all participants, to all jurors, and to all ADCE clubs to support the competition. Have a wonderful Christmas, and please remember, big ideas have the power to change the world. See you next year.